Soul Garden. Hello, magicians, and welcome back to Soul Horoscopes Update Edition. I'm your host of the universe, Christopher Wotecki. I hope you enjoy my new horoscope. This is a redesigned version. That's why I've been down for a little while. One where I can basically broadcast from my desk. I'm at my desk right now, pushing all the buttons. So thank you for your patience. This is part of the new SG Neptune we have coming up, where it's all about the viewers and for the viewers and by the viewers. And I'm going to start myself with the horoscopes, where I'm just going to do them right from my desk and not make them into such a big deal. We need to all start sharing information, is my opinion. And speaking of information, the Act 3 videos are out. If you don't know, this is the hot topic while I was gone. This is a very deep 13 to 17 minute video, depending on which sign it is, where I dive into the next 2 months. And some of that drama starts this week. You'll see here in just a couple minutes, but we've got some major changes going on that I cover. These are available for immediate download for $6.95 at soulmart.me. Okay, enough said there. Well, my Pisces, the magicians, the magic makers of the universe, so nice to see you again. Again, thank you for your patience. I do appreciate it. I think these new horoscopes will be a little more intimate because I'm a lot more comfortable at home in my desk in the air conditioning. And we're also doing some other TV production outside, so it's kind of switching of the guard. We are working this month on the I love state of awareness. Now, I love is very important. Love is what makes the world go around. Fortunately, I was able to open this transit. This week, we're going to close this transit. The I love state of awareness is basically our heart chakra, connecting to our heart chakra, connecting to source energy. And for Pisces, you do this in the moment. That's what Pisces do. In fact, the Pisces job is to bridge heaven to earth and channel love into the moment, which sounds all great and all, but it's not so easy because we're talking about your relationship to your lifestyle and your relationship to reality. In other words, you've got to make a fabulous loving reality for you to have love pour into your reality. Now, this is a relationship to your body. This is how you are in the moment, how you live in the moment. Do you live in stress? Do you live in peace? Do you live hungry? Do you live tired? Do you live overweight? And this is the potential of your magic. The more incredibly connected to your own heart you are in the moment, the more power a Pisces can do on earth. So it's a very critical, important time. As we start off on Monday, I think it's sunny and childlike. The moon is in Cancer. So emotions are focused on your inner child. It is also a love fest day on Monday. So hopefully you are really feeling the love. In fact, you're the one sign set up for it the most, but there's a lot of other stresses going on right now. And I think they may be perhaps pulling off or setting you up for some temper tantrums. I'll explain why. There's really two areas that are of critical area on Monday that set off really a whole week of issues. The first we should talk about, obviously, is the moon crossing Venus. Now, when the moon crosses Venus, it is Love Fest Day. This is the best day of the month to tell everyone you love them. This is the day where you feel the love. That's because Venus opens us up to giving and receiving. The moon is our emotion. So we are opening up to giving and receiving, and love is the most popular one to give and receive. Actually, it's all we really barter. Even hate is a distorted version of love. So as the moon crosses Venus, you're being called to open up literally into more love. And for you, this is your inner child, Pisces, so it is literally opening your heart. That's one biggie. The other, though, is Saturn. This is the beginning of what Act 3 gets so deep into, which is Mars and Saturn wrapping up basically the transit it has been in Libra. Now, for Pisces, this means it is time to get responsible about what you might ask. Well, about where you draw your boundaries. That's right. You no longer can have loosey-goosey Pisces boundaries. You must now be very firm on where you go. Since Mars is crossing Saturn on this day, as of Monday and through the entire week, you're being pushed to act on boundaries. That means weak boundaries will collapse. That means cheating will be exposed. That means bad locks will fall apart. It means it is time to get serious. And this really what separates the teachers from the followers in the next decade. And that's a lot of what I talk about in the Act 2 videos with Pisces and Mars and Saturn. So wrapping up Monday, it's a childlike day. It's Love Fest Day, but it's also the first day of getting very serious. And all the while, remember, this month's topic is living in your heart in the moment. Now on Tuesday, it shifts right away to showers, chance of storms. You are still hyper aware in your moment. That's the reason why there might be storms. And you're still focusing on inner child with the moon in Cancer. But Uranus rules the day. And Uranus rules the day, whatever is built on false foundation might break apart. There's also an opposition going on this particular day that's adding even more stress. First of all, Uranus on Tuesday says, any Pisces reality built on false straw or built on false foundation, that's health, that's work style, that's even your car going too long without an oil change, could finally break down on Tuesday. This is the final little revelation of seeing what you need to open your eyes to when it comes to how you plug into reality or don't. This opposition you see between Pluto and Venus is also, I think, a powerful turning point. Now, Venus is focused on your inner child. So on the one side, your inner child is trying to expand, open up. Jupiter is heading for this sign next year. So this is gonna be even a greater experience next year. But you're trying to basically, with Venus in Cancer, open up and have a fun time. What is the big hard? Well, Pluto. Pluto pulling on the other side says, well, you might have to reconsider who your friends are. You might have to reconsider where you see yourself in the world. You might have to reconsider title. Basically, there is a conflict between what your inner child wants and how you see yourself in the world. And that conflict might be what's holding up the entire issue of the month, which is feeling good in your moment and loving your moment. So Tuesday is an intense day, to say the least, but we'll make it through. On Wednesday, it is cloudy and still hyper aware. The moon does shift now into Leo. This means that emotions now shift to your daily reality and your health. So whatever you haven't been working on the last 30 days will catch up with you on this particular day. So that's really never any fun. But with planets, things are kind of quiet. What's happening is the moon is skirting into Leo, preparing for Lightcast Day, which will be on Friday. So you're beginning to feel all of the month's topic. You might have been working on your health all month. You might have been going to the gym all month. Now you're feeling it. As we bring our emotions into this context, and Mercury ruling the day means we're also breaking through, this is really about getting it. In fact, this might be the first day of the month you get it, period. Especially as the moon crosses over Mercury there, because that means emotions and intellect get on the same team by the end of the transit. But also Mercury in general will help you break through. So Wednesday is a day really of breaking through and understanding. On Thursday, it's a great sunny fun day. This is really what Love Fest Day should have been. Monday had so much stuff or conflict going on with pushing forward with right trust and boundary issues. You might not have felt it, but I think on Thursday you are going to feel it. The planets are super quiet on Thursday, and so we're basically just going with the flow and trying to emotionally innovate. So Thursday is a day of responding differently if you have any turbulence. Really try to get your new lifestyle moving. Plant the seeds of the new diet. Plant the seeds of the new life. That's what Thursday's about, and it's a quiet day. It's a day off. It's also a good date day for you guys if you want to, Pisces. Then we get to Friday. Oh, wait, I got to do it on camera. Friday. How about that? You get to see my hands. Friday's actually be a great day. It's a sunny and peace-casting day. It is also Lightcast Day, the most powerful day of the month to manifest our intentions. That's because the sun and the moon come together. The moon is our emotions. The sun is I love. So you love it and you feel it and you love it and you feel it and you love, feel, love, feel. And that is basically what Lightcast Day is. All right. Now I do have a present. For those watched over by GA, we'll be sending a text out with a link on Friday to help you through your light casting. So just click on the link if you're on a smartphone or copy the link in your browser. There will also be a password. This is just me here to help you get through and say thank you for all those who watch, subscribe to GA. For everyone else, you want to fill your heart with love. And you basically want to walk the earth and feel this whole day on Friday how you want your whole life to feel forever. So you're holding vibration, you're holding space, and of course you want what? Love in the moment. Remember, your job as a Pisces is to channel love from God conscious down to the moment. And so Friday, it has never been so true, that fact. Then on Saturn Day, things get a little serious on Saturn Day. Saturn rules Saturn Day on this particular Saturn Day. The moon passes now into Virgo, making you cloudy and relationship sensitive. A bit, I guess, sentimental, if you will. There's also a trine going on Saturday, which is adding to it. Now, first of all, you want to, on a Saturn day, decide. So the universe is asking Pisces to commit and decide to the lifestyle that you want. So whatever you're dreaming about on Lightcast Day, decide and commit on Saturn Day. The moon in Virgo makes you very sappy and sentimental about relationships. They may or may not have anything to do with your lifestyle, but if they do, they kind of come into play. And then this trine, which goes between Mercury up to Uranus and Aries, this trine is a plugging of your two awarenesses in the sense of, as you step into a better reality, you will see instantly with this trine that your self-esteem or confidence rises. So if you're having a problem with the confidence to move forward in your new life, just start moving. What the planets say is by moving, you will feel confident according to this trine. And just, you know, these are the things where planets never lie, so seriously, give it a good try. Another interesting thing is Jupiter. Now, Jupiter in Gemini, which is plowing ahead for the Pisces to expand their foundation. This is so that you can have your dreams come true in about a year. Well, Jupiter this particular weekend is also showing that you will see some breakthrough probably in your ability to feel good about yourself. You'll feel some breakthrough with your ability to take care of yourself. So in other words, as soon as you make this lifestyle decision, you will likely realize that it was tied to your overall well-being, self-nurturing, etc. So very powerful day on Saturday. Then Sunday, it is sunny and sentimental. I think it's kind of a romantic day on Pisces for Pisces on Sunday. The moon is well into the house of long-term relationships, so the fish are wanting to kiss and make up or hang out and that sort of thing. So emotions really are better with someone else. If you can hang out on Sunday, that's a good thing. But also Mars rules the day, which means it is time to take action, which means step forward. So whatever lifestyle you envisioned on Friday, you decided to on Saturday, you cannot procrastinate, Pisces. Get moving, get into it, get it together, take action on Sunday. Everything this particular transit is about, the better you are focused in the moment, is the more you can channel love. The more you channel love, the more you'll be in power for everything else. What that comes down to practically is how you feel in the moment. So get a move on. You're not going to get ahead at all. As the day progresses on Sunday, you will feel more vulnerable. And that's just simply because then we'll be moving into Libra. And that is what the hot topic of starting next week is about. All right, my fishy, so good to see you. Thank you for tolerating the time it took me to develop these new horoscopes. And I intend to see you on time next week. Until then, live, love, be.